Having played on over 2,000 albums, Nathan East is one of the most recorded bass players in the history of popular music. His career as a first-call studio musician spans some 40 years and includes record dates with the likes of Quincy Jones, Herbie Hancock, Michael Jackson, Joe Satriani, George Harrison, Phil Collins, Justin Timberlake, Daft Punk and Madonna, just to name a few. His contemporary jazz quartet, 4Play, have released 14 studio albums to date, and in 2014 he launched his own solo career. He sings, he doubles on upright and electric bass, he won an Ivor Novello Award for co-writing the Phil Collins hit Easy Lover, he's performed for the Pope and at the inauguration of Barack Obama. And as I recorded this video, he is about to head out on the road once more with the phenomenal Eric Clapton. He holds a private pilot's license and even performs magic in his spare time. Is there anything that Nathan East can't do? Let's get into it. Born in Philadelphia on December 8th, 1955, Nathan East was raised in San Diego, where his family moved to accommodate his father's job as an aircraft engineer. He grew up surrounded by aviation, but music was always in the house. When he was only 14, his mother bought him a $49 short-scale bass from a pawn shop, and in 1971, he upgraded to a Fender Jazz, which he bought for $210 from Manny's Music in New York. Nathan's first big break came as a member of a local top 40 group named Power, who were hired as the house band for a Stacked review. On the roster that day was Barry White, and upon hearing the group, he hired the entire band for a national tour. The year was 1973 and East was still in his teens. He became the youngest member of White's Love Unlimited Orchestra. Now, upon returning home, Nathan enrolled in the University of California in San Diego, and during his third year he declared music as his major and began studying classical upright bass with Bertram Turetsky. 3 weeks before graduation and a final recital for which he would perform Jaco Pastorius's Portrait of Tracy, Nathan received a call from guitar player John McLaughlin asking him to be in New York by the weekend to begin a tour. East turned him down, having promised his grandmother he would graduate. He even started his master's degree before Bertram pulled him to one side and told him that if he was going to move to LA and get work, now was the time, which he did in 1979. A year later, he received a phone call from renowned producer and arranger Gene Page, who he'd actually worked with previously during his stint with Barry White. Page had noticed his ability to read music as well as his solid bass work and booked him for his first big recording date, a jingle for Hertz, alongside guitarist Lee Ritner, Ray Parker Jr., Wah-Wah Watson, drummer James Gadson, and pianist Sonny Burke. All of a sudden, one of the top producers in LA was booking Nathan for sessions, which included everything from Dionne Warwick to The Jacksons to Johnny Mathis. He played on both Madonna's and Whitney Houston's first records, and he also met Quincy Jones while playing at his 50th birthday party, who in turn also started booking him. And if that wasn't enough, he was being recommended for dates by the likes of Abel Boreal, Patrice Rushen, and Jeff Porcaro. With Kenny Loggins, he played on the Vox Humana album and the hit record Footloose. He got his first gold record for Endless Love by Lionel Richie. He also made two records with Al Jarreau, meeting producer Jay Graydon and getting to play with drummer Steve Gadd in the process. Check out his solo with Al Jarreau from Al's 1985 Live in London, played on his Yamaha BB3500.
Thank you.
Still, when it comes to massive hits, they do not get much bigger than this next song. Philip Bailey had recommended Nathan to Phil Collins in the early 80s, and they went to Europe in 1984 to record on his album, Chinese Wall. The recording went great, but on the last day, Phil was wanting an undeniable hit. The story goes that the three sat down and wrote Easy Lover in 20 minutes, putting down a rough take with a view to recording it again the next day. But after hearing it the following morning, they decided to stick with the original take, and the rest is history. Here's Nathan and Phil in Japan from the 1995 Both Sides of the World Tour. Meeting Phil took Nathan's career to a completely new level. Through him, he met The Stones, The Who, Macca, Sting, Mark Knopfler, Elton John, and of course, Eric Clapton. Phil produced Eric's Behind the Sun album, which Nate played on with Greg Fillinganes. He hung out with Eric and again at Live Aid the following year, and was brought into the studio once more for Clapton's August album. Nathan has been a mainstay in Eric's band ever since, recording on several albums from 1991's 24 Nights to the Grammy Award winning multi-platinum MTV Unplugged and the 1997 Grammy winning Song of the Year, Change the World. Check out Nate's stage chops from the 1999 Eric Clapton and Friends benefit gig for the Crossroads Centre in Antigua.
If I could reach the stars, I'd pull one down, shine it on my heart, so you could see the truth.
Aside from his session work, East has continued to raise the bar as one of the original members of the contemporary jazz group 4Play, alongside Bob James on keyboards and drummer Harvey Mason. 4Play was originally intended as a fun side project, but their first album sold 500,000 copies and stayed at the number one slot in the contemporary jazz charts for over 6 months. Here they are live in Tokyo with Nathan in full-on George Benson mode. Nathan was set to test himself once again in 2013, starting out with the call to play on Daft Punk's Random Access Memories album and the hit single that you will all have heard, Get Lucky, which won a Grammy for Record of the Year. Nathan was at hand to perform at the award ceremony in 2014 alongside regulars of the original session, Omar Hakim and Paul Jackson Jr., and one or two other special guests.
From the beginning, we've come too far to give up who we are.
2014 also saw Nathan release his eponymous debut album, which he followed up in 2017 with his second solo offering, Reverence, featuring a slew of special guests, including his son, Noah, on piano. I should also mention Eric Clapton, Verdeen White and Phil Collins, who all rocked up for a killer version of Earth, Wind & Fire's Serpentine Fire. One constant throughout Nathan's career has been his long-term relationship with Yamaha, which stems right back to the early 80s and has seen the realisation of the BB-NE2 signature model. It has appeared in various iterations over the years, but whatever the instrument and no matter what bass he's playing, there's a reason Nathan East has performed with such a huge number of influential musicians during his career, be it Herbie Hancock. Eric Clapton. They carried us apart. It breaking up my heart. I knew it from the start. Or even Toto. It's because he understands the role of the bass, which is why his discography reads like a who's who of the all-time greats. Now, as always, guys, thank you so much for checking this out. And in the comments, let me know who you want me to feature next in this series of video essays all about the best bass players that the planet has ever seen. If you want to get your bass playing to the next level, make sure you go to scottsbasslessons.com and grab a 14-day free trial. It is the ultimate online bass school, and it is your opportunity to study with the best bass educators of all time from the comfort of your own home. And if you're not already subscribed to the channel, make sure you do that below and switch your notifications on as well, so that means the next time we release one of these bad boys, you'll get notified about it. Now, as always, take it easy and I'll see you in the shed.